I'm in Strasky. Can you hear me? Theta, listen. Acres is headed for Theta.
Don't build more panic. Getting a signal, but no audio.
Strasky, it's Como Raby. Acres has gone mad. He's dangerous. Strasky!
Sorry, Delta. Still no audio. Try calling from another access point.
Strasky, I can try sending...
I'm sweating in this suit.
Hey, could you maybe help? I need to get to Theta.
Help me out of here, will you? I think I need some vacation soon. Have to speak with Acres about that.
Hey, you!
Don't stand there, you know better than that. Yeah? You put in a good word for me? I'm not sure that's a good thing. Random, did you move the cartridge casing? We need to test that one before we ship it. tell when Astrid is off platform. This place turns into such a lab.
Probably for the best. Not sure I trust the shuttle train anymore. Thank you.
out of here, will you?
Stresky, you can see the Zeppelin now.
Good. Sorry about the mess. Without the positioning system, the Zeps just keep losing their set routes. Voljet did say that you could have fixed it on your side by rejigging the antenna. Guess it doesn't matter now. Are all of you coming?
No, just me, Goy, and Creer. Akers is set up being a stubborn old man.
All right. See you soon, Brandon. Happy evac.
Peter, can you hear me?
I hear you, Terry. I mean, Mr. Akers, sir.
I've changed my mind. I would like to come to Theta. Let Delta sleep.
Of course. Wow. Honestly, didn't expect to hear from you again. Such a long time since you checked in. We have a few divers in a Zeppelin surveying Lambda at the moment. I'll just make sure they pick you up when they're done.
Thank you for the warning. I'll make sure they feel welcome.
Okay. See you when you get here.
Thank you. Transport active. Unspecified cargo.
I've seen you when payload manager Alice Coster shows up. You'd let her manage your payload? What? That doesn't even make sense. Come on, stop messing around and get back to work.
Transport active. Unspecified cargo.
A Zeppelin's on its way. Better get ready. We're safe.
Oh, it's really disconcerting popping in and out of existence like that. Where are we now?
Delta. At least that's what you said before the crash.
Oh, right. Of course, is this a Zeppelin?
Appropriately named. You think it can get us to Theta?
It's a cargo transport. They use them for moving materials between the sites, anything that's too big for the shuttles. I'm sure it can carry us. Why won't it work? Come on. Oh, the tool chip is bust.
Isn't that part of the Omni tool?
Look who's been paying attention.
I had to deal with that back at Upsilon.
Then you know how it works. We need to get a new tool chip and switch it.
Care to point me in the direction of the closest tool chip storage?
I think it would be easier to just take one from a robot.
What? Just knock a robot over the head and steal their chips?
The toolbox over there says it has a stun baton. You could use that.
Come on. I don't want to hurt anyone. Isn't this a bit much?
It's just a robot, Simon.
We're just robots. Sort of. I'll get us the chip. Guess I have no choice.
Forget it, Akers.
Oh, come on.
Thanks, Simon. Don't be mad, okay? We really needed that chip. We'd be stuck here.
Could you do it? Kill a robot like that?
I get attached to them too. I'm not a monster. But in this case, it had to be done.
He was talking. I mean, he was delusional, but he seemed sincere. Present.
Yeah, well, I'm sure it's fine.
Was he really that different from us? It's just beginning to sink in. I mean, really sink in. I'm a robot.
Didn't we cover this already?
I guess I've known ever since I woke up at Upsilon. I just keep suppressing it. Like my brain doesn't want me to think about it. It's really getting hard not to think about it.
Yeah. Could you maybe hit that switch over there so we could get moving?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Really good back there, Simon. We got a slight delta detour, but we're back on track.
Yeah.
We should touch down on a cargo platform just outside Theta. Then we just head inside, grab the DUNBAT, and head down the abyss. 4,000 meters. That's a long way. We don't have to worry, though, because with the DUNBAT, the Ark could have been in the Mariana Trench. It'll hold for anything.
That's great.
And then we can start listening to other people when they talk, because that's how conversations work.
What? Oh, sorry. I just can't stop thinking about what we've become. It's clear that we're no longer human. But then how can I feel like Simon? How can I feel like anything at all? I mean, technically, I don't have any ears, no mouth. Christ, that's a weird thing to think about. I mean, I'm making sounds. I'm still saying things.
You sure are. Okay. Your new body most likely has senses similar to those you had as a human. And your mind, only knowing one way to perceive the world, superimposes that skill set on top of your new features.
So my mind is covering it up, pretending nothing's different.
If it didn't, you'd probably be incapable of interacting with the world at all. And the stress would either kill you or make you go insane.
So I've found a good balance between awareness and ignorance. Does that mean I shouldn't think about this stuff, or are my thoughts actually making me cope? Could I tip the balance by suddenly gaining some insight and then go insane?
I wouldn't worry about it. I mean, we have real things to deal with. Saving mankind, remember? Speaking of which, we're closing in on Theta. I'll eject the Omni tool. As always, don't forget to take me with you.
Kath, before you go, the artificial intelligence you mentioned in the escape vessel?
The Warden unit, the WoW.
Is it the WoW's fault that we're like this? I mean, it seems like something an unreliable AI would do.
I suppose it set the ball in motion, but it's not directed with purpose. It's really complicated to explain how machines think, Simon. Concentrate on getting inside Theta, okay? See you soon.
Strasky, wake up Dr. Masters. We're bringing in Anchors.
What's wrong?
What can I say? He's had a rough day.
Jesus Christ. He's all butchered by structure shrapnel. The valve surge and the number on him.
Brandon, flip the panic switch on the suit. I don't want to burn through the oxygen.
You're kidding, right? He's fucking hanging on by a thread. We need to move him.
Strasky, get the infirmary ready. We need to move fast.
Wait. Where are Kumaravi and the others?
This is all we got. I guess it's still at Delta.
Emma, I can't do this on my own. Grab the other side.
Strask, ready or not, we're coming in.
All right. See you soon.
thing on? Can everyone hear me?
Go ahead, Strom.
Listen up, all members of staff. The art project has caused a lot of arguments the last few months. I'm not going to pretend I understand what the hell Sarang talked about and how his continuity suddenly made sense to kill yourself. For the fucking love of God, or whatever you think is important, don't kill yourself. This place is miserable enough. Don't force your friends to clean up your blood. Rest in peace. Quality. Good?
Beautiful, sir. All right, everyone. Show's over. Get back to work.
Is everything right? Thank you, Catherine. Wait. Am I already here? I don't understand.
Hello?
Who is that? Mark?
No. We haven't met before.
Is this Hark?
I think we're safe.
Oh, I was so worried something had gone wrong.
What's your name?
Robin Bass, Theta Field Service Technician.
Nice to meet you, Robin. How did you get here?
I got scanned, like the others. And then I killed myself. At least, I think so. I can't remember that part.
How does that work? Did dying get you into the Ark?
Wow, you're definitely not from Theta. Let me guess, Omicron? Wasn't sure Catherine would be able to scan you guys. You're lucky. There was a lot of talk about this at Theta. The idea is, when you're activated in the Ark, there's basically two of you, right? One human, one living skin in the Ark. You don't want your copy to survive you. You yourself want to survive on the Ark. If the human you dies before the scan is initiated, or closely after, you yourself would live on in the Ark. Amazing, right?
Did Catherine put you up to this? Killing yourself?
Catherine Chun? No. I don't think you understand. She just did scans and put them into the Ark. I hope I get to meet her soon, so I can apologize. She always got into trouble with Strawmeyer when someone killed themselves.
I think she's okay with it.
Where is everyone? I thought there would be like 40 or 50 people here.
I don't know. I'll let you know if I see anyone. Robin, I'm not sure how to say this.
What?
This is...
Yeah?
Pretty amazing, right? I mean, the Ark.
Yeah, it's great. Catherine and the guys have really pulled through. They saved us all.
See you later.
Will do. Is this what it's supposed to look like?
I'll be going now.
Let me know if you find anyone else.
You good?
I think so. I feel fine. I expected something different.
Let me go! Stop! Stop! Stop it! Please!
Figure this out.
Hello? Anyone there? Well, Catherine, we found Theta.
Here. Okay, great. Time to hijack ourselves a submarine. There will be nothing stopping us when we have the DUNBAT.
You guys sure have a lot of machines and vehicles down here. What makes this one so special?
It's the only transport that can go into the abyss without cracking like a can of soup.
If this is one of a kind, then how did they get the Ark down the abyss in the first place?
That's a good question. I suppose they did it the hard way and just walked.
Didn't realize that was an option. Kath, what's it like inside the Ark? Is it like a movie or virtual reality?
No, of course not. It's, you know, like real life, but slightly better. Pleasant temperature, clean air, good weather.
So people in the Ark just walk around pretending it's the real world?
You don't have to pretend. It's perfectly immersive.
And it can just sustain itself?
Yes. Attached to a probe, fueled by solar panels, it could survive for thousands of years.
That's amazing. Just thinking about the Earth being what it is, and us setting out to save the final remains of humanity, it's
heroic.
At least it feels worth doing.
Here we go. The DUNBAT! Oh, damn it. I knew it was too good to be true.
What's wrong?
It's quarantined. Hold on. We need a security cipher.
How bad is it?
It's we don't write these things down type of bad.
Maybe someone's still around who can tell us what it is.
Sure. Let's go with that. I'll just unlock the other doors for you so you can explore the station.
Looks like all your friends moved downstairs.
Why abandon the gate? And the habitat? That's so strange. I don't like this at all.
Thank you.
Thanks, Strawmire. That's a real helpful report. Be quiet, the proxy listens. What happened to Theta? No explanations anywhere.
Kinda sounds like a warning. Bad, but it makes me feel a lot better. Helps me focus.
That's the wow you're hooking up to.
I need it, okay? I wouldn't have made it this far without it.
Let's just keep going. Why would they all leave this floor?
I don't get it either. It's like they all just cleared out.
Where I did my scan. And all the others, I suppose.
You don't remember?
My scan was the first. Had to test the scanner before I could start making promises. Terminal. I just want to make sure.
David Munchie. How did this... What is this? What is this? Why do you have a file of me?
You are one of Dr. Munchie's templates. A legacy scan.
Okay, that's it.
Wow, that was fun.
That's a relief. Still figuring this out, so...
This is freaky. So many lights. What do we do now?
Paul and I are gonna run tests for a week or so, then we'll work out a roadmap to your recovery.
Well, I feel excited. Can't wait to get back to the living.
We've worked everything out. Everything is legal. Vouched for by Dr. Peak and Professor Wei.
Oh, that's great news.
No big change in medication. You'll be taking an aspirin every morning, but that's about it. Paul worked out a diet with some variations you should try out. You can continue doing physical therapy. Also, there's some extra cardio training every other day.
Okay, getting complicated.
Don't worry, it's really not. We're gonna keep an eye on you every week, so we'll be able to adjust the plan if needed. The model was sound. It should have worked.
It's not your fault, David.
I really wish things had turned out differently.
Yeah, me too.
I was supposed to save you.
Hey, you got my brain on file. Maybe you can put it to some use.
Yeah, who knows? You'd be okay with that? Using it for my research?
Sure. It's like a part of me lives on or something. Like a donated organ. You know what sucks about dying?
What?
The crash. Everything up till now. The brain damage. You guys, everything. It's made my life so much more real. I started thinking about all the things I was going to do. I'd never been more excited to be alive. All that hope. Wasted.
What's a legacy scan?
They're historic templates for AI construction. Any self-respecting engineer wouldn't use legacies anymore, but they're great for learning. They come with every development kit.
So, my brain scan turned into a template for artificial intelligence.
You should be proud.
So much for that mystery. No magic or time travel needed. I was here all along, waiting for someone to shove a picture of my brain into a suit and hit the power button.
Strasky, come in. I need help in the lab, the scan room.
What happened?
Conrad killed himself after the scan.
Jesus, how?
Maser tool. What should I do?
I'm gonna need to tell Strohmeyer.
No, please. I'm so close. Strohmeyer's gonna shut down the ARC project. It's not my fault people keep killing themselves.
Catherine, what are you gonna do? It's not like you can sneak a 300-pound body out of the lab.
I know.
Catherine, are you okay?
Not even close.
Welcome to my place. When I started the ARC project, I pretty much lived in this lab.
Cozy.
This is where I would store the ARC scans.
Are they similar to my legacy file?
No, yours is flatter, if that makes sense. Less dynamic.
Thanks. That makes me feel much better. Fast. Damaged. Broken.
An intact memory chip. If we're lucky, we might be able to extract the cipher from it.
Need to fix that mainframe connection. The legacy scan of me that was on the computer. What did you use it for?
It's a template that has an intelligence password already etched into the base. So, if I wanted to build an AI, I wouldn't have to reinvent a whole model. I would be able to focus on the things that the AI is to be used for.
Is every AI self-aware? Do they also think they're Simon?
What? No, Simon. Don't worry. It's not like we just put people into robots and machinery and let them roam free. That'd be really cruel. It doesn't work like that. Or at least it didn't used to work like that. Truly sentient machines, thinking they are people, is definitely weird.
But you kept them sentient for the Ark.
Yes, and I basically had to invent the method.
I'm not worried that there are other Simons or Catherines running around out there.
Now I am. Geez, Simon, some thoughts are better left alone.
The real Simon would have thought if he knew about me.
What do you mean? You do know about yourself.
No, I mean the real Simon. The human Simon.
Going by your reactions, I'd say he'd be pretty upset. What's so interesting downstairs? Just labs and offices. Maybe the shuttle station.
Should we go check?
Rather not. Got a bad feeling about this. Maybe they wanted to keep close to the shuttle station in case something went wrong.
You're really stuck on that one.
I'm just worried about my colleagues.
Good job, Simon.
This better have worked. Going down there again.
Load up that chip. There should be a list of people. See if there's anyone who could know a security cipher.
Thank you.
No, won't work. We need someone from Theta Security Group.
I'll just load him up and get the simulator going. There we are.
What are we doing exactly?
We're gonna have a talk with Mr. Wan. Use the computer to activate the simulation.
That wasn't so bad. Stromar really got me worked up, bastard. What? What happened? Where did everyone go?
Take it easy, Mr. Wan.
Chun? What happened? I can't see anything. There's nothing here.
Don't worry, Mr. Wan. It'll all get better.
No, that's a lie. You're lying.
Don't get upset, Mr. Wan.
No. Well, why are you doing this to me? I trusted you, Chun. I trusted you!
Did we just bring that guy to life? I mean, he's a perfect scan, meant for the Ark. He's the real deal. And we turned him off. Took it all away again.
I really thought that was gonna work. Maybe we can try again.
I wish I knew Brandon better. What would make him talk?
Here we go, Brandon Wan's room. I'll just override the lock for you. If we get to know him, maybe we can make the simulation a little smoother.
Strasky and Alvaro to pack up their stuff. Head downstairs and I'll meet you there.
Don't take too long.
Don't worry, we're right behind you.
Seems like they were getting ready to leave. Heard some lady telling Brandon to hurry up.
You got that from the intercom? Must be a transmission buffer. Hang on. That's Alice Coster. Wouldn't have guessed they even knew of each other. Interesting.
Here. Seems like Alice and Brandon did their scans together.
Oh, we can definitely use that. I think we got this, Simon. I can synthesize Alice's voice from the intercom and use it to impersonate her for the simulation. We can trick him into feeling safe enough to open up.
Great. Definitely feeling good about this.
Good job with the intercom. I didn't know you could data mine. What's it like?
It's just something that I do now.
So it comes naturally to you. That's really interesting.
Yeah, I'll make sure to add it to my dating profile.
That's my room.
You want me to bring something? A souvenir?
No, it's just memories. I seriously doubt you'll find anything useful in there.
What's with the junk? Looks like something you'd fish out of the ocean.
Huh? Oh, you mean... Yeah, that's a part of Reed's vivarium. It's a long story. Forget it.
You don't have to search my room. We'll get by.
Thank you. What's the little projector? Looks homemade.
That's my attempt at building a vivarium. It's kind of a proto-arc.
Cool fan.
Thanks. Reminds me of Taipei, my hometown.
Do you know that the human body consists of up to 75 trillion individual cells? They typically don't stay with us till we die. Some live a few days, while others live a few years. We're not affected by their short lifespans, as they're replaced by new cells which help sustain our bodies. I don't think anyone would argue that we ever lose our persona due to this process. Yet we are clearly in a constant state of transformation. Then how do we remain the same? A continuous flow of thought and perception keeps an unbroken chain of continuity that we know as our self. Our conscious mind is not the pattern of our brain, but a continuous emergent entity based on that pattern. When Dr. Chun populates the Ark, she is capturing a moment of our existence and placing it inside the digital world. Soon you and your digital you will grow apart due to diverging experiences, but for a tiny window, you are the very same. With unbroken continuity, it will live on. A fulfilling life, no doubt, no less real than the one from which it was plucked. Now remember, you are not your body. You are the emergent entity. That entity just happens to occupy two places at once for a while. If you took away your body, you would simply be the only one you can be. The you inside the Ark. Let your body die and continue on in the digital paradise among the stars.
Thank you.
I compiled an Alice module that we can use.
So she'll be with Brandon in the simulation?
Sort of. I'll still need to do the talking, but it'll sound and look like Alice.
That wasn't so bad. Stroma really got me worked up, bastard.
What a relief that it wasn't so bad.
Alice, what happened to the room?
What do you mean? Nothing's changed. Everything is A-okay.
Why are you acting like this?
I'm normal, like always.
Whoever you are, you better get the fuck out of here.
Don't be upset. I need your help.
Well, what the hell is this? What have you done to me? What have you done to Alice? If she's hurt, I'll fucking end you!
Do we need to turn it off? Can we just keep him alive until we've got the cipher?
The longer he's exposed to the computer model, the more he'll get hung up on it.
So, what's wrong with letting him settle in a little?
It would drive him insane. So let's keep the session short and the suffering to a minimum.
To build the scene so it's more what he'd expect. As soon as he starts to doubt, we've lost him.
You're right. We need to think this through. We need some more data.
so bad. Stroma really got me worked up, bastard.
Well, that's what you get for listening to his stories.
I guess I had it coming.
About Stroma. He said he needed a new cipher ASAP. What should I tell him?
It's all right. I can talk to him.
Wait, didn't Chum just tell you to take it easy? Don't worry, I'm not going to tell anyone.
I do feel hungover. Okay. It's 1729 over 42, 12 over 407. Got it?
Yeah, I got it. I'm sorry, Mr. DeLong. Brandy. Goodbye.
No, wait.
That's enough. We got what we need.
Is that what we are? Simulations?
Yeah, but it shouldn't make any difference. You're still you. I'm not sure what to do with the data. You decide. Simon, we got it. We can get to the DUNBAT now. Get back here.
Just have extracted the cipher from Brandon's data somehow. It's so cruel bringing him back like we did.
No, that's impossible. Memories don't work like that.
Let's just hope it was worth it.
Warming up the DUNBAT for us. It's been collecting dust for months, so it might need a minute. Okay, that's it. That's everything. Let's go ahead and... Huh. That's weird. Never mind.
What do you need me to do?
Head inside the dock. The Omnitool can open the door now. And get into the DUNBAT. Then plug me in, and I'll take us into the abyss.
Sounds easy enough.